And we're going to Radical Train.
Yay. I'm not going to let the Iblis trigger get away. That's why I'm going to head this way.
I wanted to see if there was an alternate route, but no, you have to go down.
What about, like, you ever played South Park with Super Troop?
I've seen some of that, but I haven't played it.
And there's a part where you have to go, where near the end of the game, the story, and you have to get rid of this nuke inside Mr. Slave's ass.
Oh.
But wait, if you leave the room, the game, it just shows a generic explosion clip, and then the credits play.
What?
Like, it plays the actual South Park credits.
Oh my gosh, that's
amazing. Step down.
Yep.
Speaking of South Park, when does the next season start? Because I'm looking forward to the new season.
Oh, if I know. I don't watch South Park.
Oh.
I played the game because my brother got it.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. Sorry, Harry, you go first.
Well, I was just gonna talk about the actual level, but you can finish first.
Okay. Anyways, I was saying I thought that you would have been into South Park because you talked about the game and stuff. I thought you would have been into the actual show.
Well, I wanted to play Stick of Truth because it was more of a because it's a game. I wanted to always see. I heard good things about it, even though it's pretty damn easy.
Yeah.
Well, I don't think an easy game equals to a bad game.
Well, yeah, because, like, what's a good example of a...
I'd say Black Knight, for instance, because that's an easy game, but I like Black Knight.
Oh, yeah. Actually, while we're on that, Xavier, what's your favorite Sonic games?
My favorite Sonic games? Sonic Heroes, Sonic CD, Sonic 3 & Knuckles.
Yeah!
CD's my favorite 2D.
Yeah, my favorite 2D is Sonic CD, and then Sonic 3 & Knuckles comes at a close second.
No.
If I play Sonic 3 & Knuckles, I usually play it as a complete.
What about Colors?
Oh yeah, I love Colors.
Yeah.
Colors, Generations, yeah.
Yeah, and I actually really like Lost World as well, despite what people say about it.
So far, like, the only 3D Sonic games that I've fully played through are Heroes and Colors.
Oh, okay. Well, I recommend playing the adventure games at some point.
Yeah. Yeah, because I recently got a memory card with a lot of more space, so I'm going to expand my GameCube collection.
Nice.
Because I've only really got five games.
Okay.
What?
I have Animal Crossing, Sonic Riders, Namco Museum, and the Pac-Man World 2 bundle, which also has Pac-Man Versus.
Oh, I have that too, actually.
Hmm. Yeah, and I also got a Game Boy Advance SP so I could actually play Pac-Man Versus.
I actually got my SP for only $5.
Oh, I got mine for 40, jeez.
Well, what happened was my friend was giving it away but for $5, and it also came with Super Mario World.
Nice.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, one thing I want to say about this level, it's basically just the same as Sonic and Shadows, just with the scale things, you have to actually use boxes to change the weight of the scales, but that's...
And you're not timed.
Yeah, you're not timed here, which is nice. Other than that, it's pretty much the same exact stage.
Without the mock speed section either.
Yeah.
This is the part that leads to the shadow fight.
Yeah.
Excuse me, I'm going to be eating the Sloppy Joe in front of me.
Yeah.
So if you hear food noises, there you go. We're just kind of watching a level.
Yep.
Oh man, our commentary really downgraded.
There isn't a lot to say about Silver, to be honest.
No.
Mm-hmm.
I'm pretty sure you guys probably already joked about made the whole pothead to porcupine jokes while I wasn't here.
Oh, right. Forgot about that.
We actually haven't done that yet.
Well, there you go. I just gave you some material.
Also, I don't know if you can grind with Silver in multiplayer, but for some...
No, you can't.
Oh, right, okay. Well,
yeah, in the SP play, for you see Silver grinding rails in Crescent City.
Yeah, but in single player, you can't do that for some reason.
I don't know. Inconsistency.
Yeah, because I'm trying to go on it here, but it doesn't work.
I tried to grind, but it's no use.
Because I remember seeing this,
you can grind that Zero Gravity game.
I haven't played Zero Gravity.
Oh, I've played Zero Gravity. Zero Gravity is pretty fun.
Yeah, it's easily the best of the Riders trilogy.
Yeah,
It has a bit of take used to. The controls are a bit to take used to, especially when you compare how that game controls to how the original Sonic Riders controls. Yeah. Both of those games have a bit of a learning curve, but once you get past that, it's really fun to play.
I usually one of those guys who always does tutorial first.
I think that Zero Gravity is actually easier to get to understanding than the original is. Mm-hmm.
Well, the enemies aren't as brutal.
Yeah, that's the thing with the original, like, it doesn't let up. Like, the CPUs are just way too good.
To be fair, in Riders 1, for the story mission, they at least the first two things are a bit lenient. They just say you don't have to get first, you just gotta get the top three.
Yeah. But when you get play Babylon's story, I think you always have to be first.
Yeah, you always have to get first.
Yeah, but that's because you have to do so in Sonic's story first, so...
Yeah. And it gets pretty obnoxious later on with, like, the desert level, for instance.
Yeah, I hated trying to beat the desert level missions. And when you clear it first as Sonic, in the end, it doesn't even matter.
Yeah, I still need to go through all the missions in Riders.
I've gotten Super Sonic.
Yeah.
Why? I will pull back. I bought Shadow, like, Rose on the floor there, like, his face was straight down, and then...
Yeah, when I edited this part, I saw a similar thing. Like, it looked weird.
Nah, for that.
We're not seeing that cutscene a third time.
Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah, this is the same as fighting Sonic. It's just there's not as much things around.
He's a bit more resilient.
Yeah. I think he's just like. He's more defensive, I'd say.
Did he just take Shadow and Sonic's little tornado attack?
I think so, yeah. So if you go near him, he just does that.
Ow.
And he just says,
what no. Hitbox? What are hitboxes?
Yeah, he just says no when he does his spin attack.
Yeah, because you were nowhere near him and that hurt.
Yeah.
Well, the moment he activates, that's when the attack box activates.
Yeah.
Well, that's Sonic 06 for you.
Yeah.
Love the song, though.
Yeah, the music is good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I prefer Generations version, but yeah, I still like this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but is the same song that plays when you're fighting Silver? Oh, god damn it.
Yeah, it plays when you fight Silver in Generations.
Yeah. Like, are you the real Sonic or a fake? I'll find out by throwing cars at you.
Oh, and then a giant Katamari Damacy ball.
Yeah. I still need to play Katamari because that game looks super. That game looks fun. It's weird, but it's the good kind of weird.
I love the music because I'm a big fan. I'm a sucker for J-pop.
The music, especially like the main theme, it's pretty much stuck in everyone's head.
I
Katamari Damacy.
I haven't played or seen that.
Oh, by the way, I remember the brain scratch playthrough. Yeah, you see how like Silver was floating right there?
Yeah.
What happened in that playthrough is after they beat Shadow, he was directly under him because of where he was in the map.
Yeah.
Just in the camera. So he's just like Silver's like murder. Are you gonna do an edit with this one too?
Yeah. Well, we see the boot to the head again.
Chaos control. Let's see what you do this time.
Drop kick.
so you just did nothing this time.
Wait, it's coming.
What did he do?
You.
Forget this. I can't be asked. And what was funny if the audio was also sped up.
It's silent.
Well, it did that in the program, but for some reason when I uploaded it, it just cut the audio.
Yeah, that was
actually, that was just you. Oh, I thought the music was dead for the level. But damn it, because I actually like Aquatic bass stream.
Yeah.
But, so you play a Silver for 15 seconds and you go straight to Shadow.
Yeah, it's like... Wait, what are you going to say?
Because Shadow's the coolest.
Yeah, this is kind of silly, because like, we already played the stage with Shadow in his story, and we're going to Silver's part, version of this level, and we're just going straight to Shadow. And this And this opening is the same as Shadow's version.
You know what's weird, though?
What?
When you do Crisis City, right before with Sonic and Shadow, it's like, alright, Shadow, looks like we need to work together. Yeah, that's the only time you don't switch.
Yeah. You don't play as Sonic in, like, Crisis City with Shadow, or the other way around.
Well, more it's like, you don't switch between the two, and...
Yeah. And now we get to play Silver.
Yep.
What troop is he looking for? This is who I am?
This is who I am!
This is who we are, this is who I am! And if you get that reference, then you need to think again. If you don't get that reference, then you need to think again.
I do like that that reminds me, there's like this one song, I think, from Shadow the Hedgehog. It was a song that got called Who I Am. I've heard that song and it's amazing.
I've heard that it was supposed to be the original main theme.
Yeah, it was supposed to be all instead of I Am.
Yeah.
But man, I love that. I heard the song. I love it.
I've only heard a bit of it. I need to.
Keep a shortcut.
Yeah.
There you go.
Because screw playing the game normally.
Yeah, because like the laser has like is actually a solid object, so you can actually stand on top of it.
Even if you got hit, you still got to at least land on it.
Well, I think if you stand on it, I don't think you take damage. I could be wrong though.
Programming.
Yeah.
Yep.
Guys, if Bayonetta didn't win the Smash ballot, who would you have? Who do you think would have made it in?
Banjo-Kazooie.
Oh, I wish.
You both voted for Banjo?
Well, I had to put in Waluigi.
I voted for a few characters, actually.
My brother was hoping Shantae and Shovel Knight.
That's me too. For me, it was either Shovel Knight or Shantae, because
yeah.
I think they'll
love their games.
Part of me wants to believe that they're saving some of the other characters for Smash 5 if that happens. Because I feel like characters like Inkling especially would be perfect candidates for Smash 5.
Yeah, with no question. The Inkling was definitely a shoo-in for Smash 5.
Yeah.
The guy at least has a thing as a Mii costume, which I actually did get for the 3DS version.
Yeah.
Like the trophy.
Yeah, the trophy. Yeah, that was good too. But when they were announced as Mii costumes, I was a bit disappointed. But then I was like, you know what? Maybe next time.
it's kind of fair enough because they're essentially just Mii gunners.
Yeah. But the only costumes I'm probably gonna get are the Tails and Knuckles one, just so I can have an excuse to say that Team Sonic is in the game.
Yeah, I'm gonna get those costumes when they come out. as far as other costumes go, I'm probably gonna get the hoodie.
I have the t-shirt.
I'm gonna get the Viridi costume. Ooh, I'm gonna get the bear costume so I can have a Nicolas Cage me. So I could make a Nicolas Cage me and put him in the bear costume.
What? Okay, I don't get the joke.
Oh, because there was a movie called he was in called Wicker Man, and there was a scene where he punched someone while he was wearing a bear suit. I don't know. I haven't watched the movie.
Huh.
But I mean, I know about it from Nostalgia Critic.
Oh.
And he even like made a bunch of bear jokes.
I try not to make stupid memes. The only one I have as an exception is Lonk.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. I have the Link costume and I used it for Lonk.
I have Lonk and I have Hercule.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, and I also have a Peach, but there's no Peach costume, sadly.
Yeah. But does that matter? I named my my Peach amiibo High of Daisy.
I'm gonna get a Peach amiibo at some point because I know they're common as hell.
You have any amiibo?
Oh yeah, I have Villager, Pac-Man, Sonic.
Where do I begin?
The Retro 3 Pack, Zero Suit Samus. 8-bit retro colored Mario and
nice.
The Inkling boy and Inkling girl.
Nice.
Oh, where do I begin?
I bet you have all of them.
I don't have all of them, but I'm looking up at my mantle right now, and I'm waiting which one to tell you first.
Well, I can tell you right now, I have none.
Yeah, I,
I know someone who has all of them.
My friend Liam
does. I'm pretty sure he's got like. I'm pretty sure the completionist has all of them.
Yeah, probably.
See, I see Lothario, Duck Hunt, Mewtwo, Dr. Mario, Little Mac, Robin, Lucina, Marth, Ike, Mario, Dr. Mario is out there with right next to him, by the way. Yeah. Zero Suit Samus, Fox, Sonic, Bowser Jr., Captain Falcon, Olimar, Greninja, the Inkling Boy and Girl, I have Ganondorf, I have Zelda, I have Link. Let's see, I have Luigi, I have Peach, who else am I missing? Pac-Man, Game & Watch, Rob.
Dang.
Yeah, and I don't think I'm even done.
Oh my gosh.
Like, yeah, this is why I bought the Retro 3 pack.
Oh yeah, we have Villager, but we haven't opened it because my brother's a picky asshole like that.
Oh wait, is it the first edition or is it the reprint?
No, but he insists on keeping it in the package.
Why?
Because he's stubborn. We also have Ball Free Yarn Yoshi.
I want the Yarn Yoshis, and I want the giant...
I want that big one.
Yeah, me too. I want the big Yarn Yoshi.
I want the Yarn Yoshi. It looks so adorable.
Well, the big one especially, I have no shame saying I want to cuddle it.
Yeah, yeah.
Because it's so big, you can cuddle it.
Yeah, it's like a plushie.
I think that's the point.
Yeah. Yeah, and I like that it's so big that the amiibo chip is on his foot.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah, the amiibo chip is on his foot. It's not on his butt like with the others.
Was this underwater?
You can see the water down there, but
the water kind of looks weird.
Yeah,
it looks like gel.
I can kind of see.
You mean the one on the floor?
Yeah, on the floor. It looks like gel.
Yeah. Well, we're not playing Portal 2, so unfortunately.
You already had that commentary done, don't you?
Yeah, we did a 4-2 commentary, and that happened.
Oh no.
Well, that'd kill myself.
If this was Portal 2, that would probably bounce me, because that looks kind of like blue gel.
Yeah, it looks like the blue gel.
Yeah. But here, I'm just like, screw the big ball thing, I'm just gonna float over.
Big ball.
Indeed.
You love them balls. Obligatory high on a Him Daisy reference.
Yeah.
What is there? What else haven't we? What haven't we talked about in this game?
I think we've pretty much run our course. If Silver had more character, we'd have more to say.
Yeah, I've already said it, but as a character, I don't mind Silver, but I don't care for him.
He needs more.
I don't care for him in this game.
Okay, then let's talk about Persona.
I've never played Persona.
Play
yeah,
it.
Bye bye.
It's a really good JRPG. Well, Persona 3 and 4, anyways.
Why? No, you finish first. I was gonna go on.
My first exposure to Persona was at Persona 3 FES on the PSN.
Oh.
Yeah, but here's the thing though. It's an Atlus game, and I think you've heard about their. I think you've heard about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we know about Atlus.
Yeah, didn't Atlus Sega and buy Atlus?
Yeah, it was Sega too.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's right. Sega owns Atlus now.
Yeah, yep. but Atlus games are notoriously difficult.
Yeah, I've heard.
Right, I played Persona Q, and my God, I died on normal mode.
Jeez.
I'm the first mook. Well, I didn't game over. More specifically, what I meant to say was my protagonist died. Luckily, I wasn't playing Maniac difficulty, otherwise I would have game overed.
Oh my gosh.
Well, I should mention that in the mainstream Persona games, the protagonist dies, game over.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm. And the thing is, there's stuff that insta-kills you.
No, I hate insta-kill stuff.
Well, because there's a light... The light Hama skills and the dark Mudo skills, and you don't know when it's coming. Until it happens. Looks like
I'm on a roll. No, you're not.
You're not even close to being on a roll.
I think I'm a half second behind you, but whatever.
Oh, yep. We still got like 10 minutes. Or like, more like 6 minutes, but still.
Yeah, 6 minutes. That went pretty well.
Yeah.
And now we get this kind of cutscene. Let's, if come on, hit the Are you not?
I don't know why I'm taking so long.
Yeah, probably taking the recording.
Probably. But yeah, like I said, I'm usually in a Skype call when I record playthroughs.
Where is this room?
And how did he get here? He was, we saw in the cutscene that he was struggling.
Well, you said earlier, no you didn't, we sped it up. So that's how I caught you, you were stuck in your speed up.
Yeah.
Yes, he powers speed up.
He's even faster than Sonic.
He's faster than Eggman. And even Eggman's faster than Sonic.
Well, Blaze is faster than Sonic in this game.
Yeah.
Also, where'd you get the Chaos Emerald?
He had it.
For some reason.
The living flame that has been entrusted to the royal family.
Why does he have a Darth Vader thing on his chest?
Yeah, that's a good point. He's secretly Darth Vader confirmed.
No, when he dies here, he becomes Darth Vader, and that puts him as the tutorial bubbles.
Star Wars is now canon in the Sonic universe.
Also, yeah. That beam is clipping through her body.
Yeah.
And now he dies.
Yeah. I remember seeing something like this in Sonic Shorts. I saw this scene in Sonic Shorts.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah, this scene in Sonic Shorts. Young Elise wakes up, Silver tries to tell her the bad news, and she starts crying right away. And
it's just screen. Like time paradox.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Future screwed.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't get the joke at first, but now that I know more about it, I'm like, oh, now I get it.
Yeah.
Really pathetic. Yeah, but he's looking, it's kind of bullcrap. You really expect at least not to cry for so long?
Yeah, no, everyone said that at this point, but it's just a stupid plot device.
Yeah, it is.
Like, especially after hearing her father die, there is no way in fuck this is not, he's not crying.
Yeah, like, her parents are dead and she's like a really young girl, so.
She's Batman.
Yeah. No, she's Batwoman.
Batgirl.
Yeah, Batgirl, yeah.
Well, unfortunately, she doesn't become as, like kind of like a Batman character.
No.
Can you imagine carrying young Elise through the level, backwards through the level now?
Probably.
She gets a shield just like Sonic.
Well, she's unconscious, though, so.
Yeah.
I'll tap into her hidden powers of Iblis.
I imagine if Iblis is like, so, she needs. I imagine if Iblis is like, here, play Mother 3. Here, play Mother 3. Try not to cry. Try not to cry. I bet you can't.
Mephilo should have just done that. Yeah.
Kill Mother 3.
Yeah, here.
I haven't played Mother 3 yet.
Oh, it's a good game, but you will be feeling the feels.
I played a bit of Earthbound. I just got Jeff.
I beat Earthbound.
I'm kind of just waiting until like an inevitable release of Mother 3 happens for like.
I get the feeling there might do that on the Wii U eShop.
Yeah, me too.
Come on, Reggie, give us Mother 3.
I mean, they gave us this. Mother 1.
Yeah, we got
Fireballs.
Yeah.
That's pretty good, actually.
I actually downloaded Earthbound Beginnings as well, actually.
Actually, wasn't that a Japanese-only thing?
It was ready to release here, but they did. But the Super Nintendo was the main focus at the time, so they just scrapped it.
Plus, it would be.
Yeah. Plus, it would also. Plus, those carts would kind of be expensive to produce.
Yeah. So instead, they just held on to the English carts over here until they decided to put on Earthbound Beginnings.
Yeah. Basically.
Wow, so they literally had no excuse not to do Mother 3 now.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, if they translated it, but if they just go to Lazy Run and use the fan translation, that would be good, too.
Well, I don't think people would care if they got the fan translation. They can probably buy it out like they did with Street Fighter Cross Mega Man.
Mm. Yes. Yeah, I think that's what they should do. They should, like, talk to the team who worked on the fan translation and say, hey, we want to use your version of the game in the Virtual Console re-release. And they're like, go for it.
In the scene.
Yeah.
So, since Elise has the Blue Emerald, does that, like, make it so Sonic can never go super in the games?
I don't know. Yeah, this is 10 years ago.
Yeah.
But here's another thing. If you do Shadow Story, when Silver and going through, he's still holding the Emerald.
Yeah.
Weird.
Inconsistency, thy name also is where
so... Also, where did the Scepter of Darkness go?
I don't know.
It broke. Crap, Nepalus.
Why don't they just throw the Scepter of Darkness in like a volcano or something?
Because I don't know. The ablest trigger wasn't. I don't know. It might shatter.
Yeah. Well, wouldn't they just kill Nephilus, though?
Crowd of people noises.
There's no one there though.
Yeah. I heard that the princess here left for. Yes. Look at all these invisible people.
Look at all those Eggman's robots.
Yeah, and now they suddenly just stop talking. What if his
ultimate objective was? It's because they hear. It's because they realize what plot they're in.
Yeah, they're like, oh shit, we're in this game, we out.
Rob in, Rob out.
Yep. Perfect. End part's done.
Perfect end.